Hello and welcome to the Getting Started video for pCon Planner Web. With this powerful and intuitive tool, you can create impressive room plans directly in your browser, flexibly and without any installation. This video is an introduction to the essential features. We start with the first launch of the application. Explore the user interface and learn how to draw a room, insert room elements, and finally furnish it with real products and materials from the pCon catalog. We'll also take a look at how you can save and share your design. To start using pCon Planner Web, first log in with your pCon login account. As soon as you are logged in, you will be taken to the start screen. Here you can start a new project, open existing projects, select sample projects and room layouts, or import floor plans as images or rooms from pCon scan. For this tutorial, we will select new project to start together from scratch. We are now in the main window of pCon Planner Web. The interface is clearly organized so that you can quickly find your way around. At the top left is the application menu, the File, Edit, Insert, View, Presentation, and Help tabs. Directly below this is the ribbon bar, which provides quick access to the tools of the respective tab. The workspace, where the actual planning takes place, is located in the center. Finally, at the bottom left is the view control, which you can use to switch between the 2D and 3D view and adjust the function of the left mouse button. On the right, you will see the sidebar, which gives you access to properties, architectural elements, and the product catalogs. At the top right, you will find information about your pCon login account and the settings. Here you can adjust the unit of measurement, whether you want to use a grid in the planning or activate the dark mode. Navigation within the planning area is intuitive and easy to learn. You can select an object by clicking on it. Hold down the right mouse button to move the view. Use the mouse wheel to zoom in or out. If you want to rotate the view, hold down the mouse wheel or shift and the left mouse button. On laptops, you can activate the rotate view function at the bottom left to navigate with the left mouse button. Here you can also switch to multiple selection, which allows you to select several objects by dragging a rectangle with the mouse. Now let's draw our first room together. To do this, switch to the 2D view. Open the Insert tab, go to Architecture, and select the Draw Wall option. Click on the desired starting point of your first wall and drag it with the mouse, or enter the desired length using the keyboard. Confirm the placement with another click. The next wall is immediately connected to the previous one. If you want to change the orientation of the wall, click the Control key. If you hold down the Shift key while drawing the wall, it will snap into place in 45 degrees angle steps. You can also end the drawing process by right-clicking or pressing Escape. To continue drawing on a wall, you can select it and choose the green pluses button, or use the Draw Wall command to start at any point. As soon as you have created a closed room, a floor is automatically added for this room. If you draw additional closed rooms, they will each have an individual floor. An area and perimeter calculation is displayed in the properties, and you can select predefined materials for the floor. If you select a wall, you can see its properties. You can adjust the position using the interactors. For closed rooms, the connected walls will also change. If you click on a wall dimension, you can adjust its length. In the dialog that opens, you can also specify the direction in which the length is to be changed. If you want to undo an action, you can do this with the shortcut Ctrl and Z, or in the Edit tab via Undo. You can change the height and thickness of the wall via the Properties dialog. A special feature here is that you can select a wall, enter your value, and then tick Apply to all walls to apply the change to all walls in the planning. You can specify colors and materials for walls per side. You can see which side is which in the 2D view with an A or B next to the respective dimension. Once the room has been drawn, you can add various room elements, such as doors or windows. To do this, click on the wall into which you would like to insert the element and select the corresponding option. The position of the element can either be changed using the navigator or by entering a dimension directly. By right-clicking and selecting Rotate, you can define the opening direction and handle position of room elements such as windows and doors. You can make further settings in the property editor. Here, you can change the width, height, color, or material of door leaves and window frames. There are individual features for all inserted room elements that can be customized in this way. This flexibility allows you to design your room exactly as you want it. A special highlight of pCon Planner Web is the direct connection to pCon Catalog. Click on the corresponding symbol in the Insert tab or in the sidebar on the right. The pCon Catalog gives you access to a vast selection of real products from various manufacturers' brand catalogs. You can select products from the catalog and insert your saved favorites directly into the planning. Many products can also be configured individually, which further increases flexibility in planning. To do this, click on the icon on the product and choose a suitable configuration. Click on Insert to place the product directly in the planning area. By using the interactor to simply move and rotate the products, they can be positioned precisely in the room and combined to create an ideal solution. And now comes the real trick. If you have added a configurable product from a manufacturer in the pCon catalog, you can reconfigure it at any time. To do this, open the properties and click on Configure Model. Make the changes, click on Apply, and the product will be updated in the planning. This allows you to quickly and efficiently implement customer requests during the planning process. Materials can be assigned just as easily as products. In addition to models, pCon Catalog offers access to a wide range of materials, from carpets through parquet to wall colors. Select a material from the overview and click on the surface you want to use it on. As soon as you have chosen a surface with the mouse, it will appear either red or green. A green marker indicates that the material can be assigned, while a red marker indicates that this is not possible here. In this way, you can, for example, visually enhance walls, floors, room elements, and shapes, and give your planning a personal touch. Once the planning has been finalized, you have various options for presenting your project. In the Presentation tab, you can create snapshots of the current view to save images from different perspectives. You can then view these in the gallery and download them from there. To control what can be seen on the image, you can do this in the View tab. Here, under Visibilities, you can select whether the grid, floors, dimensions, and walls should be shown or hidden. Under Sun, you can set the height, direction, and intensity of the shadow cast, and thus influence the lighting mood in your design. By right-clicking in the design, you can also hide a selection or everything except the selection. It is also possible to share an interactive insight of your project. Under Presentation, you will find the option to generate an Impress link. This allows you to share your project as a 3D or AR model and project it directly into the room. This makes your planning not only visible, but also tangible. This technology is particularly useful in sales or customer meetings. To enable you to edit your planning at any time or share it with others, you have various options under File and Save. You can save your project locally on your computer or send yourself a link to a copy of the plan via email. Alternatively, you can use Download to save the planning in PBOX or USADZ format and download all images from the gallery. If you want to continue working on a saved plan later, you can call it up again at any time via the Open Menu item. This keeps your work flexible and accessible at all times. That was our introduction to pCon Planner Web. This tool provides you with a powerful and versatile planning solution that impresses with its easy-to-use and extensive functions. In the following videos, we will go into more detail on topics such as importing and tracing floor plans, editing materials, and using other functions. Thank you for your attention. We hope this tutorial helps you to successfully master your first steps with pCon Planner Web. feel free to leave any questions or feedback in the comments. Have fun planning and experimenting.